always remember us and know that we glorify you. O Noah of all things, past, present, and yet to come, give us the knowledge to glorify your name. O thou Noah, let us partake of your knowledge. O thou watcher, be forever close to us. And O thou light, enlighten us with the strength and inspire us to walk the straight path, as you have given the inspiration to those who were before us, the chosen ones who have joined you already. And because we are constantly tormented by evil, we ask that you awaken us to those things that can sway us from the path of righteousness. Surely you are able to respond to this cry for help, for surely you have the power over all things. Any gift that we treasure in this world, we know is from you, Allah. For the gift of will could only come from you. Neither might nor power exist as it is found in you. I have placed in my unshakable faith in you, Allah, because I trust in you. I seek refuge in you. I want nothing save to return to you. In the name of Allah, I affirm that my sustainer is Allah. I am satisfied with him. I place my trust in him, and I am concerned with no one save the will of Allah, mashallah. Because you are the standards by which I judge all things. There is no strength but in Allah, and there is no might or power except in Allah, the Most High Sustainer and Great. O Allah, send down your countless blessings and let them rain on our noble Prophet, Apostle Mustafa Muhammad Al-Amin, the seal of the prophets. And forget not his unconquerable companions, for they all deserve to know your divine peace. In the name of Allah, the will is Allah's, and his alone, and no one directs goodness except Allah. The will is Allah's, and no one can dispel evil save he, Allah, who wills a thing to be. The will is Allah. There is no strength and no power except in he. Surely I believe in Allah, and I return to Allah, and I depend on Allah. And he is my reckoner, and excellent is he, the advocate, the defender. In the name of Allah, my sustainer is Allah. My reckoner is Allah. O Allah, I depend and I hold firmly with Allah, and I entrust my affairs to Allah. The will is Allah's, and there is no strength or power except with Allah. There is no strength nor power except in Allah, the exalted, the supreme. Our reckoner is Allah, the excellent is he, the advocate. So if you recite, our reckoner is Allah, and excellent is he, the advocate, recite it, and on Allah we depend also. And if you recite it, and on Allah we depend. O Allah, surely I glorify you, I bear witness to you, and I bear witness to your angelic beings, and your prophets, and all your creations. Surely you are Allah, and nothing creates except you. You are alone, no associates have you. And surely, our noble prophet apostle Mustafa Muhammad Al-Amin is your servant and apostle. I seek forgiveness of Allah, the great, and nothing creates except he, the ever-living and the all-sustaining. I turn to him, a humble servant in repentance, for I have not the power to control my destiny, my death, or my resurrection. I seek forgiveness in Allah the Great. Send your blessings, O Allah, upon the Prophet Apostle Mustafa Muhammad Al-Amin, the noble seal of the prophets. And know that nothing creates except Allah. And the Prophet Apostle Mustafa Muhammad Al-Amin is an apostle of Allah. Peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. Nothing gives life save Allah. He is alone and has no partners. Unto him, Allah, is the kingdom of the galactic heavens and the planet Earth. He gives life and causes death, and he, Allah, has power over all things. Glory to Allah the Supreme, and his is the praise. Glory to Allah the Supreme, and praise be to him as much as his creation. And as he contented himself and is immense as his throne of the heavens and the earth, and his words are extended. Praise be to you as much as your gifts, and sufficient is your provisions. And to you as much as your creation. And peace and blessings upon our noble prophet, Apostle Mustafa Muhammad Alameen, our access to you, and blessings upon his family and companions. There are those who do your divine work, and they are rightly guided by your prophets. I beg of you, by the right of the chosen ones, your prophets, the truthful and the reliant, to make our hearts acknowledge your greatness and splendor. Teach us to praise your name, because you have absolute power over all things, and our hearts yearn to understand the words we recite when glorifying your wondrous name, Allah. And we submit to you, our sustainer, creator, and we seek refuge in you, Allah. You can raise the heavens and the earth with only a command, and you can resurrect the dead with nothing but a summon. When you will a thing, all you must say is be, and into existence it comes. Allah, you are clearly the possessor of all things, and all things are clearly in your hands. So gently restore our hearts, so that we may fear you and seek righteousness, for we yearn to feel your cherished love. And only you have the supreme power, the power to show mercy and the power to mold man. So make me not one of those who turn from you in rebellion and forget that his life is by the grace of Allah. For surely the wrath of Allah is a greeting of grief, O sustainer of all the worlds. O Allah, who is that approver? You are the answerer of our many prayers. You answer us when we are in distress. You answer our calls when we are standing in the midst of destruction. And you answer our grievous cry when we can no longer stand and are on the verge of a collapse. For you are merciful. And surely I am in need of your mercy, for without it, I could never escape the bottomless pit. O sustainer, please heal my sick soul and keep me close to you. For you are my only salvation. Respond to us, O merciful one, so that we can respond to your words, which live in your glorious Quran. And teach us the meaning of your profound words, which are divine revelations from you, the creator of the heavens. Surely, the yielder is the one on the throne, the galactic heavens and the planet earth and all that is between both of them. And whatsoever is beneath the fertile soil is only for him. And if you, Prophet Apostle Muhammad, speak out loud saying anything, he Allah knows. For surely he Allah knows every secret kept in your heart and everything kept hidden or whispered. My eyes are not open to your magnificence, and consequently, this crippling blindness causes me profound inadequacy. In the presence of one such as yourself, who is majestically settled on the throne, sustainer of all the worlds, show us mercy. O thou, you are the assistant of the distressed, the greatest of help, so please assist me in this fight with myself. For I long to be rid of the wickedness that defiles my very being. And do not allow me to lie down in ignorance, wallowing in all those things that can keep me from knowing my spiritual essence. Because you are the generosity, and I beg you to please enlighten me so that I can flee this physical confine, my body, and disappear within my divine self. O you who make me stand alone and gives me friends to consult me, control my heart and make it only receptive to you and not to those bodily senses that chain me to the world of desire. Make the understand and communicate your message, for I want nothing but to serve you. And please know that my obedience to your command exemplifies my faith and make me understand the secrets of your scriptures. As your favorites, the prophets understand them. For these holy words were sent down as a guidance for the chosen, those who are near to the truth. O thou who is abundantly merciful to those who show an abundance of mercy. You are the greatest, and nobody can grant greatness save you, the all great. No one can make the meek stand erect save your magnificence. For you give your humble servants all their submissive heart's desires. O sustainer, I humble myself before you, begging that you reward me by revealing the secrets of your divine scriptures. I yearn to read with my heart, for I crave to understand your celestial teachings. And you are the all-observant who sees all we do and hear all we say. You can read deeds as well as intentions, for you see the essence of man. You do not like vice and corruption, and I submit to this, for my life is in your hands, and in you lies my salvation. O sustainer of all people, to you I entrust my affairs. So beautify my state as it pleases you, and let me hearken to your words of guidance. O Allah, let my heart know the intensity of your love, and touch my heart as you touch the hearts of the chosen, your apostles, those who are close to you because you have honored them for righteousness' sake. Your creations mirror your goodness, and those divine reflections of you make me appreciate obedience, and most of all, mindful that nothing parallel to you, for you are the maker and the master of all things. You, O sustainer, created me from a little more than nothing, and there was no mediator between me and thee. And so I ask you, O merciful sustainer, to shower me with your mercy and make me one of your helpers and not one of the helpless, O most yielder of the yielding. O Allah, nothing can render you impotent, invalid, or inept, for you are the maker and I am your submissive servant who longs to be content with you. I beseech you, O sustainer, to slaughter those dreadful yearnings inside me for the things of this world. And please place not a shield between me and thee, because you are he who created me, and my fate is in your hands, as is my return from the grave. And I seek refuge in you, O Allah, from the demons sealed within me. And hear my prayer, for you are the grace, and I ask that you regard me as one of your steadfast servants. Ameen. O sustainer of all the worlds. O you who is most splendorous and generous, I give up myself to you, Allah, and I seek refuge in you from myself and anything that could lead me astray. There is no secret alive in my heart that I cannot share with you. For you are surely the master, the maker, and the sustainer of all creation. There is no comparison to you, for you are clearly the possessor of all possessions. And if my mind must engross in anything, let it be totally committed to loving you, Allah, and following your guidance. Thus, I ask you, Allah, not to leave me unprotected and alone, for I will surely go astray, fall down, and wallow in the slime of the earth. O sustainer, please do not chastise me for my misgivings. Enlighten me with your celestial light, and know for a certainty that I seek refuge in you, the all. I seek refuge in you from the evil whisperings of the jinn and man. And because I know you, the master, the sustainer of all people, cannot be overpowered by any force, I surrender myself to you, seeking your shelter and belief.